all the data that you get while you're here. So that's the local memory we were talking about for the virtual reality character, right? The virtual reality character does his thing. He fights his battles. He slays his monsters. He does all that. And that doesn't get forgotten. That is stored somewhere. Well, with us, it's stored here. So can you lose that? Well, sure. You know, if you have an accident and half your brain's gone, you'll act different. Because a lot of what you had stored in the relationships that you had connected this time is going to be gone now. You can't access it anymore. That's basically the local memory for that character. That's the local thing. But besides that, you're not just local, you're consciousness. So you have this physical brain that just represents your experience here, what you came in with and your experience here. Now, as your experience here changes, and as you grow up, your brain changes. So the things you do actually change your brain. It changes your physical body, just like it keeps your car running. You know, your mind leads, the physical follows. Mind is fundamental, physical is virtual. Okay. Thoughts and experiences modify brains. I'll tell you a little bit more about that because it's got a practical application. There was some research done that these biologist types, they dissected a sheep brain, and they looked at the sheep brain, and they saw certain constructs there of the sheep brain, and they said, well, look, this explains why sheep have certain kinds of moral behavior. Now, the moral behavior they were talking about is that a sheep, if a mother was killed before it could raise its sheep, other sheep will take, other adult female sheep will take in the baby sheep and feed it and take care of it and raise it like their own and that kind of stuff. So that was seen as moral behavior. They helped each other even when it cost them their own resources, their own energy and effort. And these biologists said, but it's because the brain developed, this little part of the brain that does that, that's why they were able to do the moral behavior. But it doesn't work like that. It's just the opposite. The sheep develop moral behavior out of caring. Their consciousness is just like anything else. They're evolving like anything else. They develop the moral behavior, and because they develop that behavior, they also develop that part of the brain. They change their brain because the brain has to represent the being. The being comes first, the brain then represents it. So you got to get it in the right order. Science now has it backwards. They think the physical is dominant, everything else is a derivative. It's the other way around. The physical is the derivative. Now here's a more practical side of that. So let's say you go to a horror movie, and in that horror movie, watch some maniac with a chainsaw do a lot of terrible things. What does that do to your consciousness? You experience that. Well, it depends. Or let's say you play a video game, and in that video game, a lot of awful things happen. What does that do to your consciousness? Well, maybe nothing, maybe something. Depends on how much you're connected to that experience. If in that horror movie, you're really frightened. You're one of those people that scream, when the big hand, comes out from behind the door or whatever. If you're really into it, that's a frightening experience. You are really frightened. And that frightening experience will change your brain. Now you've just modified your system just a little bit because now you've got that fear experience in there, and that's something yet to overcome. You're worse off than before you went into that movie. If you're a child, maybe a more dramatic example, if you're a child and you're 5 years old and you're coming down the street and you get assaulted and both of your parents are murdered right in front of you, does that change you? Yeah. Is it permanent? Well, sort of, for a long time. You have to outgrow it. It's the same thing. That doesn't just change you psychologically. That changes you physiologically, too. Your brain changes. You're a different person after that. It's organic. It's not just, we can talk to a shrink and work through it. It's not like that. It's an organic change. The brain has changed because of that experience. The mind leads, the body follows. So if you spread a lot of joy in your life and you're around a lot of happy things, or if you spread a lot of misery and you're always around miserable things, it changes you. You see, it gets into a spiral. This is evolution. So, whatever you do, it's easier to do more of that. So the more negative you are, the easier it is for you to get negative. And it's basically a spiral. The more positive you are, the easier it is for you to be more positive. So you can get into these things and they do affect you physically. brain changes. Now, let's say you've been negative. Let's say you went to a horror movie and you got terrified. Then how do you get over that? Well, you can outgrow it. You can outgrow anything. The child who saw his parents die can outgrow it. It's not easy for him because that's very traumatic. A horror movie is not all that traumatic. Now, if you were in that horror movie and you just laughed at the whole thing because you thought it was ridiculous, you know, it was a poor movie and, you know, the hand coming out, you know, like, you know, how predictable, you know, and you didn't have that reaction, then it's not going to do anything to you. If you play that video game and you're not sucked into the violence, it's not going to have much effect on you. You see, because you're not experiencing it. If it's an experience of yours, it will affect you. You're affected by your experiences physically because that experience is your consciousness experiencing, and that consciousness creates you. All right, next one. Okay, so that's kind of a wrap-up of what we just said. Consciousness drives the physical brain state. Physical brain state represents the present you. It's the primary source of your thoughts and actions. Okay, you have an accident, you lose part of your brain, and you know, you may change your personality, or you may not know as much as you used to know. You may lose memory, all kinds of things like that. Take a computer. You know, take one of the chips out of the memory, and does the computer work the same as it did before? No, you know, it's the same sort of thing. The consciousness is hosted, if you will, in the physical system, in the hardware. This is the hardware. You know, it's hosted in the hardware. And if the hardware doesn't have the capacity to host the whole system, then you know, you don't get as much out of it. But does that mean then after you've had this brain damage and then you pass on the other side that suddenly you're crippled, you've got this problem? No, of course not. That's just a representation of your experience in the physical. When you let that go, that's gone. You move beyond it. Everything you learned is still with you, even if you were a vegetable, you know, before you left. It makes no difference. It's not like that sets you back. It just keeps you from going forward. It's just an accident. Things happen. You know, there's random. Everything here isn't planned. Random things happen all the time. But effects are accumulative. So if you go to 100 horror movies, you're going to have 100 times the effect. Now, that effect may be just negligible. Even if you get scared in it, it's probably a very small effect. It's not like having your parents murdered in front of you. You know, that's a big effect. This going to a horror movie is just a little effect. But all those little effects add. All those little effects, all the negative behavior, all the awful things that you have to experience add. So don't experience any more awful things than you absolutely have to. Don't go out of your way to experience, you know, things that are not pleasant and uplifting. Try to avoid those. Okay, the last thing here is the concept of bootstrapping. Your interpretations of things and what you do and all of these experiences, like I say, they're all cumulative, they've added, they change you, and they can very slowly raise you up. You ask back here, what do you do to raise your, you know, what are the little actions you take to raise your quality of your consciousness? It's all these little things. It's thousands of tiny things all add up together, and typically you don't do an aha, you know, I did something great today and now I can just feel I'm really grown now. You know, it doesn't work that way. It's the tens of thousands of little things that add together, and then you look back at how you were 5 years ago and then you go, aha, I've really grown a lot since then. But it's the tiny increments that add up.